Welcome to this new episode of your weekly program, Game the Name. Our sport today is Hillis Shooting. And our guest is Great Britain's Diane Rogers, Hillis Shooting European and World Champion. So if you want to know more about her and about Hillis Shooting, stay with us. Hillis is a form of competitive shotgun shooting. It is in the family of clay target sports, but a Hillis target is actually made of plastic. Originally, Hillis shooting was created to simulate a form of live pigeon shooting.
Yes, my name is Dion Rogers. I'm from London, in the UK. Okay, the sport that we're shooting today is called Hillis. We call it Hillis in the UK. It's a simulated version of live pigeon. It's very, very popular here. You have a beautiful club. In the UK, we have a very small amount of shooters. We have only three grounds in the UK. My particular club, we only have one ring. So we're very proud to come and shoot at such a beautiful club with multiple rings. Okay, well, I've been shooting Hillis for 35 years. I have been all over the world, and I can say with my hand on my heart, this is the best club I've ever been to. It's fantastic. The atmosphere is wonderful. The company, the competitors, everybody is happy. The facilities are wonderful. It couldn't be better. Well, yes, I have been shooting a long time. I am 7 times world champion, 7 times European champion, and in the UK I am 28 times British champion. So I have a lot of achievements, but each one is special. Yeah. So every event is special. Well, we have a lady here, Sophie Leonard, who is very good. She's from Belgium. She did beat me yesterday, unfortunately, but we had a very good shoot and a fantastic barrage. And with this sport, we always say you have to shoot well and have some luck. Yeah. So maybe I was a little unlucky yesterday. Yeah. Well, this is a very difficult sport to prepare for, because it's not like clay pigeon shooting where you can practice. With Hillis, it's a very natural kind of shooting. So you never know where the target is going. So if you have a problem with birds going left, you cannot ask the trap to repeat. So it's for me, it's the purest form of shooting, and it brings out the best talent, the people with the most natural talent, I should say, not the best, but the most natural talent. And also, it's a big mind game. Well, again, in going back to the UK, we have very limited facilities. So our training is very small. We shoot competitions, and that is our training, if you like. But I suppose when you've been doing it so long, you know, it's kind of ingrained. But some days you shoot well, some days you shoot bad. Yeah. It's a very fine line. Again, you know, we're a very small country. In the UK, we only have three police rings. We have one south of London, which Chris Potter, myself and Robert and Henry Arnold own or run. And we have one ring. And then we have another two clubs north of London and one 2 hours north of London, which have two rings. So considering we're such a small island with very small facilities, the GB team does very well, and I'm very proud of them to for them to do that. That's a difficult question to answer. I just think that we have a few talented few. We have maybe 20 people in the UK who are capable of winning you know, top places. But I think, you know, there is this desire to win, but then there is talent. But yes, we're very lucky. But I think also we're very skillful.
Yeah.
Well, practice makes perfect. Practice does make perfect. So we all shoot a lot of competitions. We come abroad and shoot as many different clubs as we can. And really, when you shoot Helice, it's really experience. For a beginner to shoot Helice, it's very difficult. It's very difficult to train. So you have to, I think, be more of a natural shot to succeed. To Egypt last year, just four of us, and we had a fantastic time. And we brought two new shooters with us for this weekend. And honestly, as I said before, the facilities, the club is fantastic. I have no feeling of doubt whatsoever. And that is the message that we will take home to the UK. It's a beautiful, beautiful place, beautiful people, and from our point of view, there's no doubt that we will try and bring with us 15, 20 shooters to the World Championships in October. Well, Helice is not an Olympic discipline, so we weren't able to compete in the Olympics, but I went to London to watch the shooting. And it was fantastic. The atmosphere was fantastic. But once again, I have shot all over the world. Spain, Portugal, Italy, Argentina. This is the best facility, really. Really. And I'm very happy to be here. And I will be very, very happy to tell my fellow shooters when I get home that they must come.
In today's episode of Games and Names, our sport today is Helice shooting. And our guest is the British Chris Potter, international British shooter. So if you want to know more about him and about Helice shooting, stay with us. Helice is a form of competitive shotgun shooting. It is in the family of clay target sports, but a Helice target is actually made of plastic. One shooter is on the line at a time, standing on the edge of a circle facing five or seven machines, about 30 yards in front of the shooting line. When the machines are turned on, the plastic targets with helicopter blades begin to spin on the machines. When the shooter calls for the board, one target is released. It can go in any direction except directly towards the shooter.
My name is Chris Potter. I come from Great Britain. I'm on the technical Helice Commission for the world, but I'm also British team manager. So I look after a group of 15, 20 shooters who travel the world, shooting everywhere. My history, I have a gun shop. My history with the sport is that I've been shooting it as long as it's been in Great Britain, which is now 35 years. We've been very, very lucky. We've had some very good shooters for such a small community. We've had some very, very good shooters, ladies, juniors, everybody. It's a sport, for some reason, British shooters can excel at. We don't know why. We come here, you have some terrific shooters here, but we're competitors, we can play, and we don't really know why. There's three clubs in Great Britain, so we're a very small group, maybe 40 shooters, 50 on a good day. So it's a small community that we have in Great Britain.
Great.
Do you have all day? Okay. It came from live pigeon shooting. When Princess Grace went to Monte Carlo, which was the biggest live pigeon club in the world, she banned live pigeon shooting. So there was a Belgian count there who tried to come up with an idea that something would fly like a live bird, which is what this is trying to do. Because it does not fly straight like a clay target, it will weave in the air like a live bird. And if you hit it, that is not a kill. You must separate it, and the white, the heart of the target, must fall then within the 21 meter circle. So it is a difficult sport. Some shooters don't like it because it's unfair. You can be a very good shooter and get very, very difficult targets. You can be an ordinary shooter and you can get some very shootable targets. But generally at the end of the competition, the cream rises to the top. The good guys, good ladies, whoever, are generally near the top of the results. But there is a chance, complete outsider could come here and win today or tomorrow. And that's what makes it so challenging. What I like about here at the moment is what I'm seeing, there's 160, 170 shooters, but they're not all shooters. They're hunters, they're different walks of life. I mean, obviously, we travel the world and we meet 30 or 40 Egyptians who are now our friends. But here now, there's a different community. There are different people, which I'm, even the hunter out there is shooting badly. He seems to be having fun. He seems to be enjoying the sport. Whether it relates to hunting and the dog flushes a bird and it's the bird that gets away. Everybody seems to be enjoying themselves at this sport. But it is difficult. And one day you can hit them all and the next day your hero to zero, as we say in England, that all of a sudden it just goes away for no reason. It's a very, very difficult sport. When you do it right, it's the greatest sport in the world. When you do it badly, I don't want to do it anymore. So it's a very strange sport. That is correct, because this is a reaction. Nobody gets the same target. You cannot practice the same target or the same angle because you will never get it again. So it is obviously for shooters who have some ability, but if you are a natural reaction, go straight to the target and pull the trigger, then you see some different results from different people. People who may not be very good at clay pigeon shooting or may not be very good at hunting, for some reason they shoot this very well. It is a strange, unusual sport, shall we say. Well, I've been on the International Commission now for probably 15, 16 years, and what we're trying to do is to bring new shooters into the sport to encourage them. In the old days, they had what they called elimination. If you missed four targets, you came out of the competition. Well, that's not a lot of fun. If you traveled to Europe or come to Cairo and you miss four birds and you're eliminated. So we're looking all the time of improving to try and make it more user-friendly for shooters to have a good time. It costs a lot of money. Time you fly, hotel, shoot, you know, it's not a inexpensive sport, it's fairly expensive, but if you've enjoyed yourself while you're there, then people will come back. So on the commission side, that's what we're trying to do, to make all the layouts, all the rules similar for everybody. So if you shoot it here, come to England, it will be exactly the same. Go to Spain, Portugal, Italy, the rules, the layouts are identical. There's no variations on it. So by keeping it as a standard discipline, I think it has helped the sport. And we take advice, we listen to the shooters. If the shooters come up with an idea, why are you doing this, why don't you do this, we will sit around the table and talk about it. And if it's a good idea, okay, we change it, let's do that. It seems a very good idea, it's something we hadn't thought of. So we do listen to the competitors, because they're the customers. I mean, we may sit on a commission, but without the competitors, there is no commission. So we do listen to whatever the competitor has to say. Well, as you said, I was at the London Olympics as well, and I was pleasantly surprised how well it worked, because on the British Commission we had problems with the Olympics, because it cost $35 million to build it and then $7 million to rip it down. There was no lasting legacy, which is what we were promised. Yeah. But what made it work was the staff, the way it was run, and you've done it here. The staff are happy. Behind the counters, taking our money, they're happy, they're helping us. They know we don't understand Egyptian money, but they help us. This has a great atmosphere, and I overheard Dion say this is the best club we've been to, and it is. You know, we're not saying it just because we're on Egyptian television or I'm talking to you. You know, we have shot everywhere, and we've been to some very nice clubs, and we've been made very welcome, but the atmosphere is good. They congratulate you if you do well. The staff are helpful, it is clean, it is tidy. We sat last night and Bob, who's never been here before, I brought over this time, he said, I couldn't tell you how you can make this shoot better. It runs perfectly, it starts on time, everybody knows what they're doing. It's good, it's very, very good. You should be very proud of it, Cairo. Yeah. Well, we have the Europeans first in Rome, which obviously we will go to in June. But then we are planning to come here. Depending on costings, pricings, I would hope 20 British shooters. Maybe a few more. We will see. We will go back and spread the word. And Bob and Andy have been taking pictures of the facilities and talking to people. So we will spread the word. So hopefully I'm expecting a minimum of 20 shooters to come. Obviously, I'm also very friendly with the Americans. I will try and get... I know some are already coming, but we will try and get teams here. In all the disciplines, from juniors, ladies, veterans, super veterans, and so yeah, no, it's going to be a good event in October. The only problem is you may be a victim of your own success. You may have so many entries, it may be a very, very long day, but we're prepared for it. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here, and thank you, Cairo. Thank you, Egypt.